As of November 15th of 2023, there are currently 46 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet. One of these erupting volcanoes is Italy's spectacular Mount Etna, which has been erupting at low intensity for the past several months. Then, on November 12th, Etna produced a short yet violent burst of activity referred to as a paroxysm, sending towering lava fountains to a height of 650 meters or approximately 2,130 feet. Lava flows were also generated by this latest paroxysm and appear to have traveled at least a distance of 2,500 meters since then. With this being said, here are this week's major volcano-related news stories. Due to the world's gaze being tuned to the already damaging volcanic activity in Iceland, two other stories were largely overlooked. First, in Indonesia, the Dukono volcano produced its largest eruption in nearly a decade, depositing more than an inch of ash on a city of more than 30,000 people. Meanwhile, in Hawaii, not only has inflation been ongoing and a spot on the Kilauea volcano's southwest rift zone, which has not erupted in 49 years, but also earthquake swarms recently shifted further down that very rift zone. With all of this being said, our main story covers the significant ongoing volcanic unrest in Iceland. In the last 7 days, a magmatic intrusion which was originally centered 3.5 kilometers north-northwest of Grindavik moved towards the east before forming a 15-kilometer long dike intrusion which stretched underneath the town of Grindavik. As a result, Grindavik was fully evacuated. Large cracks then formed in the ground, and magma at one point may have only been at a depth of a few dozen meters, with a volcanic eruption seemingly only minutes away. Yet, an eruption did not occur in the subsequent hours, and instead, ground subsidence occurred, suggesting that magma was moving elsewhere. If we look at the amount of ground deformation between November 12th and November 14th, a crater row known as Sindahyuka-Kigerer had the highest amount of uplift, while regions to the south all showed subsidence. This suggested that magma at depth was draining away and moving towards the north, before subsequently moving upwards once again. While a volcanic eruption could now still theoretically occur at any point along the 15-kilometer long dike, it now appears that the most likely location, if an eruption was to occur, is currently an area known as Sindahyuka-Gigerer. While a volcanic eruption might not occur, the odds of one occurring in the next 2 weeks is still fairly high in my opinion. Sulfur dioxide was even detected on both of the last 2 days, suggesting that some form of magma may exist at only a few hundred meters depth or less somewhere underneath Grindavik. Meanwhile, in Indonesia, the Dukono volcano on the island of Halmahera just produced its largest eruption in nearly a decade. This increased activity seemingly began on October 20th when the amount of volcanic tremor at this volcano, which has been continuously erupting in an explosive manner since 1933, started to increase. The increased activity was likely triggered by an increasing supply of magma, which, starting on October 29th, began producing an increasing number of volcanic explosions. Whereas on November 4th there were 30 explosions, each day since November 8th has altogether averaged 109.7 explosions. While only a maximum plume height of 1,500 meters above Dukono's central crater was observed, surprisingly heavy ash subsequently began falling on the city of Tobelo, with a total of 3 centimeters thick of ash falling during a 48-hour period between November 8th and November 9th. This, at one point, reduced visibility to only a distance of 20 meters or 66 feet, causing an alert to be issued that people should temporarily avoid all unnecessary outdoor activities when ash is falling. While there is still only a 2-kilometer exclusion zone around Dukono's crater rim edge, in my opinion, I would recommend that this radius temporarily increase to 5 kilometers. In Hawaii, the Kilauea volcano has been at a raised alert level for some time now, as during much of the last month, it has shown signs of unrest. These signs include ground deformation indicating the influx of magma, but also a more unusual aspect of earthquake swarms being centered in its southwest rift zone, which has not erupted since 1974. Then, beginning on October 30th, earthquakes suddenly shifted to a location 4.9 miles to the west-southwest. However, these quakes subsequently ceased and since November 10th have been ongoing via a moderate intensity earthquake swarm at their original center during the majority of October. Yet, these earthquakes and ground deformation do not yet seem to indicate that a volcanic eruption is imminent. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on November 15th of 2023. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.